In the previous clip, we have seen how the energy radiated from the sun interacts with the atmosphere and the Earth and controls the distribution of temperatures and the first order pattern of wind circulation on the globe. Temperatures and winds interacting with continents and ocean control precipitations and ocean currents. Temperatures, winds, precipitation and currents, all major players in controlling climate and exerting a major influence on the distribution and type of sediments. Because climate is so dependent on a large number of phenomena, often interacting in a very non-linear manner, climate change is the rule rather than the exception. Scientists predict that climate change will impact a large variety of phenomena, some of which are shown in the slide. 10-15 thousand years ago, the climate was also very different from what it is now. Huge mammoths were walking around in what is now my office, and herds of giraffes and crocodiles were populating the vast sandy regions of the present Sahara Desert. Reconstructing climate changes occurring in the past and understanding the controlling processes is of great importance. It helps in developing better scenarios for climate evolution in the future and to improve our ability to predict the type of sediments we might find in the subsurface of the Earth. All first-order tasks of you, future geologists. Already from the two examples shown in the previous slide, you can see that climate has changed in different times of the Earth history, with very different wavelengths and consequently driven by very different processes. Let us look at some examples. We'll start with phenomena which have taken place in the recent past, geologically speaking, obviously. In the plot displayed in the slide, you can see two curves showing the changes in carbon dioxide and in temperatures over the last 400,000 years. The data are obtained from ice cores from Antarctica. The two curves show important oscillations with temperature values oscillating by nearly 15 degrees, huge changes. At times, temperatures were low and presumably large ice sheets covered large parts of the Earth. In the integration period, temperatures were higher. During time periods with low temperature, glaciers were very widespread. Large amounts of water were trapped in the polar regions and sea level was lower than at present, exposing large parts of the continental shelf. Because of the cold climate, only limited vegetation was present. A large amount of terrigenous sediments were transported to the sea. In the North Sea, for instance, sea level was so low that villages developed on the Dogger Bank, a region presently under 10 meters of water. In warmer interglacial periods, such as the one we are living now, the ice caps are small and the sea level high, resulting in continental shelves largely underwater. Vegetation can flourish, thereby limiting the amount of sediments being produced and delivered to the sea. Let us now look in more detail at changes shown by the curves. At the right hand of the diagram, you see a major increase in CO2. This increase has been associated with the beginning of the Industrial Revolution and is considered the driver of climate change. If you now look at the remaining part of the diagram up to 300,000 years ago, it is clear that major changes have taken place in CO2 and therefore temperature. A striking feature of the curve is the cyclic pattern. This means that temperature oscillates with a recurrent time length and not in a random manner. A very clear wavelength is indicated by red arrows and correspond to duration of about 100,000 years. Shorter wavelengths are also visible, such as the one marked by the blue arrows, which is roughly 20,000 years. What is the origin of these irregular patterns? The changes mentioned are related to regular modification of the position of the Earth with respect to the Sun, and therefore of the amount of energy received by a certain region through time. From astronomical studies, we know of three major cyclic changes. Together, they are called Milankovitch cycles. Precessions refer to slight changes in the angle of the Earth's rotation axis. Obliquity refers to the angle the Earth axis makes with its plane of rotation, which is called the ecliptic. Eccentricity refers to slight changes in the ellipticity of the orbit of the Earth. As a result of the subtle change in the position of the Earth, the amount of energy irradiated reaching a specific surface of the Earth changes regularly through time. This can result, for instance, in regular modification of the temperatures, which itself has an impact on the amount of organisms living in a certain lake or sea. In the picture, you see a beautiful example of sedimentation modulated by Michelangelo's signal. Here, the whitest layers are rich in carbonates, while the darker ones have a higher proportion of shales. Climate change can also occur at a larger time scale. The two curves on the plot show changes in temperatures and sea level during the last 600 million years. Clearly, the two curves change in a parallel fashion, raising an interesting question on why this occurs. In the plot, you can recognize also some fairly regular changes, this time at wavelengths of tens of millions of years. These are less defined than Michelangelo's cycles and must have the very different underlying causes, possibly related to plate tectonics. A time interval of great interest is the Cretaceous, which was characterized by warm climate, high sea level, and thereby limited production of terrigenous sediments. In a previous clip, we have shown that the plate tectonic setting in Cretaceous time was characterized by a large ocean elongating east-west direction, which resulted in weak currents. Hot temperatures, little terrigenous input, great conditions for hydrocarbons to develop. Not surprised that very large portion of the rocks generating petroleum were deposited in this time frame.